Fuck.
The recording started, by the way. Hello, world. I'm Churgo the Second. Today I'm joined with Callie and Nate. How are you guys doing?
Blarg!
Nate's trying to throw me off the stage. Way to go, wrecking your own theater.
I can fix it!
So we're coming to you from the wonderful Globe Theater, bringing you some bullshit thing I came up with a few minutes before. Sorry for the webcam, I'm gonna make that better for other videos, just don't worry about that right now. So basically what we're going to do is you're going to make stories! Yay, stories! Yay. And the stories are going to be made from, we are going to get a random genre, character, and location, and we just kinda have to roll with it. While we're doing it, we can tag out pretty much at any time to make the next person go. The rotation order will go me, Nate, Callie. So it'll just go to the next person in order.
Ladies first.
Okay, fine. Callie, me, Nate. Or technically I did the roll that said Nate was starting it, so I guess Nate first.
Wait, Callie, you're forgetting. You're forgetting. It was right the first time. Him. He goes first. Ladies first.
I'm gonna hit you both.
Push.
Regardless, I have the rotation order here, so Callie is after Nate, Nate is after me, and I'm after Callie. And since I did a pre-roll that says Nate's doing it first, Nate, get in center stage. And I will begin your rolling. You can just tack out by just kind of jumping off the stage. When it's after you've said stuff, you can't just tag out immediately, that's unfair. Alright, ready to get your preliminary stuff?
Yes.
Alright, so you're going to have to come up with a fantasy story about Justin Bieber in the White House. And action.
Hear ye, hear ye! Justin Bieber declared president of Canada, United States, Landia! Everyone kill yourselves now! Yo! Splat!
Alright.
The get end.
Get up there, Callie. Continue this. Keep it rolling.
Oh, wait.
Boo!
I'm at the highest seat.
Killed themselves a fancy, wonderful necromancer, who shall not be named, came back and brought everyone to life, and then everyone teamed together to hurt the necromancer, but it didn't work because necromancer and dead things, and yeah.
Okay. So then, Lord Justin Bieber of the White House decided that he needed to save his subjects from the necromancer that brought them back to life to suffer by his hands. So, he used his horrible girly voice to shatter the soul stone of the necromancer and then stabbed him with a microphone. Alright, no. Threw a sharpened water bottle at him. Attacked with a sharpened water bottle. And then his subjects were safe to kill themselves. Nate.
Still the same thing?
Yeah, just keep going.
Ow, everyone died.
Okay, should
he
we
said
just say-
everyone was safe to kill themselves, so they did.
Callie, get up there.
Happy endings.
Alright, Callie, you will be giving us a drama story about Mario in Venice. Oh god, that actually worked out.
A drama about Mario in Venice.
Venice, yes.
You bitch!
Can I get some dramatic music?
Bum, bum, bum,
bum. It was Venice. The year doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter. Mario and his beloved Princess Peach were strolling along the beautiful alleyways, looking at the local vagrants, smiling, waving, acting all high and mighty, if you will. And suddenly, Bowser. Oh, how Mario hated Bowser. For years he had been Excuse me.
Bop, 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 bop.
You left the game in the middle of my story. How dare you?
To be fair, it wasn't my fault.
Did Minecraft crash?
I don't care.
The game crashed. I have no control over that.
I'm gonna if it makes you feel better, I'm gonna egg the crap out of him when he gets back.
So it would never crash, but it still does.
Why?
It wasn't because your story sucked balls.
Are you saying
at all?
Stuff?
Not to your face.
Oh.
And then Nate died. The end. So wait, does that make it my turn?
Yes. Go.
Yes.
Okay. Somebody finish the couch and make sure it's all symmetrical. Okay. So what happened? Bowser came in.
Yeah.
Us.
Alright. Mario and Bowser had been rivals for Peach's- EGG THE CRAP OUT OF HIM!
Da 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 da, I'm back!
Alright, so Mario and Bowser had been romantic rivals for Princess Peach for years. Mario had played it
Boo.
Cool. I'll beat the shit out of you later. They had been romantic rivals for years. Mario would take a smooth approach and be there for when Peach needed her. Bowser had a frickin' kidnapping complex and kept trying to force her to like him.
But to be fair, she probably just let it happen. You don't get kidnapped that many times.
But while the two of them were competing for her love, she went out and was doing other things. Not with either of them, but with Luigi. No, wait, no. But with Waluigi.
That's how Rosalina was born.
With Waluigi. Nate, go.
Fuck you.
You now have to write a dramatic... Now you have to give a dramatic story about Peach and Waluigi. Good luck.
It turns out Waluigi has ass cancer. How is that for drama?
Shower him in money!
Wee! Casa all the money!
Are we gonna call that the end of that story?
I'm on Waluigi! I have ass cancer!
Oh wait, no. How did they cope with this? How did they cope with Waluigi having ass cancer?
Bowser found out and got pissed, and so he removed Waluigi's ass cancer and made a monster out of it, and it ate everyone.
Well, that was dramatic.
Yay!
Okay. So as we wrap up this story, it occurs to me I probably should have done a level test before we did this.
What did you do?
Oh well, no time like the present. All right, sorry about that, guys. We are back, and it is now my turn to start off a story of weirdness.
Yay!
Okay. What do we got here? Let's see. I am going to be telling a comedy. Should we make this a rom-com?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm gonna do the same thing I did with this for another one. I'm going to roll for two characters. Okay, so we have a rom-com about Harry Potter and Robin Hood, taking place in Middle Earth. Oh wow, this is gonna be fun. Okay, and action.
I heard taking place
in Middle Earth. So we've got a rom-com about Harry Potter and Robin Hood in Middle Earth. Okay. The day was just like any other day in Middle Earth. Robin Hood was going from village to village, stealing from the rich and giving to himself. Because, you know, there aren't poor people in Middle Earth. There are just elves. Elves. Stealing from the elves and giving to himself because he was a dwarf.
He didn't have anything. Holy shit, I can hear shit now.
But this day, things were going to get strange, because he was going to be introduced to the new, Black Wizard. Harry Potter.
Black Golf?
Black Golf. The two of them,
Gandalf the Black.
Their paths crossed as Harry was, sent to Mordor to throw the Elder Wand into the fire to destroy it because they can't fucking do it in their world.
Plot convenience.
Because plot convenience, yes. Yes. So, they met there while Robin Hood was taking all the money he stole and hiding it before the police could catch him. Okay, Callie. I mean, Nate.
Question. Is this human Robin Hood or the furry animated one?
I don't know, Nate. You're next. Tell us.
So this seems like a really, really bad fanfic.
It's a romantic comedy. What do you think?
So it is a fanfic.
Everything we're technically writing right now is a fanfic, so yes.
And so they journeyed to the volcano for like 3 movies worth of content where they just walked like this. Well, that was running. There was a bit of running. And some walking. And more walking. And a bit more walking. And some running again. And some more running. And they killed some stuff. Like a tiny little bit of stuff. Robin Hood killed an elephant. By himself.
An elephant or an olifant?
Both. Take that, Legolas.
You see, that one counts as 2.
And then they arrived at the volcano. Because they totally just walked into Mordor. Take that guy. It's Callie's turn.
Oh, wow.
This story has too much comedy. It needs more romance. Give me romance!
And then they have a giant orgy!
Oh yeah, I can get off to that. The best part is the audience had to sit there watching me go through my inventory looking for it. It's just like, oh, I wonder what he's gonna be using that for. Oh god!
So, they got to the volcano. Yeah, volcano.
Yep.
And Harry threw the Elder Wand into the volcano. Then Robin Hood was like, "Harry, you're my hero. I love you." And then they made out, went home, and lived happily ever after. Next turn, yay!
Robin Hood sounded kind of like Mario there for a second.
And I'm gonna jump on the stage. And then they got AIDS. The end.
Well, to be fair, we're missing themed music for it. We need some theme music for that whole scene. I have it.
Do 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 do
da da.
Yeah, that works. All right, Nate, you're back up.
Is it a new story?
Yeah, a new story. Okay. I'm just going to check off the stuff that we've... Give me a second to check off the stuff we've done.
Okay.
Harry Potter.
That's what those are. Rose bushes.
Justin Bieber.
I saw something that looked vaguely like spiderwebs being thrown at me. I'm like, ah!
So you are going to be telling us a sci-fi story about Matt Damon.
No.
In Japan. Action.
Basically a sci-fi movie in Japan. Why do you keep throwing shit at me? Oh wait, I'm playing Matt Damon. Matt Damon.
I'm gonna throw Ender Pearls at you because they're probably gonna hurt me. Oh god!
Yeah!
Not a good idea. Okay, let's rein this back in.
Matt Damon.
Are we gonna let... Do you want to take your turn, or do you want to throw him back on the stage and make him actually say stuff?
Make him actually say stuff. Get up there.
Nate, get on the stage. No, you're not Matt Damon. Matt Damon is saying stuff. You're making Matt Damon.
Matt Damon.
Make Matt Damon talk, puppet boy.
Why doesn't someone else go up there?
No, I'll translate for you.
Actually, I do. I want to see this. I'm just saying, I want to hear this. Go ahead.
Okay, alright, Nate, go.
Matt Damon.
Matt Damon was a lovely, lovely man who was visiting Japan on special business. Now, mind you, Matt Damon is a character of lovely, lovely proportions. Nate.
Matt Damon.
And one day, as he was leaving his hotel, someone screamed, Matt Damon. Matt Damon went up to this raving fan and was like, how may I help you, miss? The chick was just like, oh, I love you, Matt Damon.
Matt Damon.
And Matt Damon was like, oh, I'm flattered, but I don't feel that way. You see, I'm gay, and you look like a man, but that doesn't mean you have the parts of a man, so therefore, I do not love you.
I ship it.
Nate?
But there's no sci-fi.
Matt
Damon. It's a very, very gay man.
Suddenly that ship from Star Trek I can't remember the name of suddenly shows up and he's beamed aboard. There's your sci-fi, asshole.
Hey, don't blame me. I mean, that's what the dice said.
Screw your dice.
All right. Callie, you ready for your next story? All right. Let's see what the dice want to give you. The dice will give you a horror story about Donald Trump.
So just look up any article about current news.
On Mars.
Okay, don't look up any current article about the news.
Alright, okay. And go. Okay.
Just action. Just insert Donald Trump into the main role of that Total Recall film. There you go.
Action.
Trump becomes president of Mars. The end.
And Mars explodes.
Okay. And even if there were life on Mars, they exploded with Mars because Trump became president and...
So that's why there's no life on Mars.
I was gonna turn this into like he became the president of Mars and then like he got rule over the xenomorphs and went to Earth and made them build the wall across the Mexican border.
Why go for that?
No.
And then ate all the Mexicans.
Nick, he didn't build a wall. He didn't want to build a wall on Earth. He built a wall. Built a wall around Mars.
Let's see what we got here. We've got. Ooh, I get to choose my own for this one. Let's make this.
Can't be about ponies or friendship.
I've just got to come up. I'm coming up with a genre right now. Crap. Oh, let's make this an action movie. An action movie. About Naruto. Well then.
What is it?
You want to talk about fan fiction, right?
Is it Naruto screwing someone? Because I can look up that fanfic.
An action movie about Naruto.
It probably exists.
No. An action movie about Naruto in Equestria.
Oh, I can actually look up that.
Oh, God. It was a normal day in Equestria. Everyone was enjoying themselves. It was all good. Everything was rainbows and happiness. But then, evil Will Ferrell showed up and started terrorizing people, gunning them down left and right. While using them to run horse carriages because they couldn't afford cars. Because gasoline isn't a thing and it's very expensive. So everything was up to one fateful hero to stop Will Ferrell from destroying everyone.
Will Ferrell is overrated!
Naruto! Nate!
Well, since you wanted to add in Will Ferrell, I'm just going to completely rip off power to this new series show. And Bruce Willis showed up. And plot twist, Bruce Willis is a dragon.
Well, I mean, roar and all that shiz.
Oh, there's Bruce Willis now.
Roar. Roar.
Roar. Oh, roar. And then Naruto probably killed Will Ferrell. In a giant, bloody Rasengan mess. And there was probably a big orgy, according to fanfiction rules.
You got that right. Okay, we'll do one more story, and then, we'll call it.
Okay.
Okay, so, since we did go through the rotation twice, anyone want to take this?
I'll take it, I guess.
You'll take it? So, I'm just going to give you the heads up now. You're going to be able to choose your own characters. Or character or characters.
Still 11.
Okay, yeah. Characters. This is going to be a buddy cop about whoever you say in Niagara Falls.
Oh, God.
Waterfall Security?
I mean, I would watch that movie.
Paul Blart, Waterfall Cop.
I would watch it. Like, I'm not kidding, I would watch that shit.
Okay, I need two unlikely people.
What do you mean, unlikely? Do you mean unlike a bull, or...
Completely hapless
Two people you wouldn't see together.
You mean unlikely? You mean unlikable or hapless morons? Because if you're looking for hapless morons, you happen to have two right here.
Good point, I do.
Buddy cop about me and Nate. Okay, I gotta hear this.
Ah, Nate, you shot me in the leg. What the hell?
Get up there.
I missed. Okay, we're gonna act this one out.
All right, Nick, up here. Nick.
Up here. Okay. Hey, I got a gun. Get down. Get down. I've been using police brutality. Get down.
Niagara Falls. Peaceful. Or is it two unlikely partner, Churgo the second?
Hooah! Hooah! Yeah! I'm gonna shoot everybody in this room!
Niagara Falls. will no longer have to worry about pesky, horrible
Terroroids.
Because we will shoot everybody in this room.
Nick, the trigger happy cop.
Oh yeah, police brutality and all that.
Sounds like he's jerking off.
I know. Really excited about his power.
I am mad with power.
I'm here, Nick.
Oh, Jesus!
What am I doing?
Nick, it is your job to take out all the terrorists.
All the terrorists?
All the terrorists.
I see some terrorists everywhere. I've got terror vision.
Nate. Man, that can look pretty. You've only got a few more terrorists left, Churgo. Kill them! Okay.
Plot twist, I will beat them back with my passion. Oh! That is the power of America.
Beep this. I'm out.
Anyway, guys, that was something.
I feel like I hit the
police brutality
world that it turned.